Hello everybody, Lord Agion here with another Wargame Red Dragon replay. Spot on the top side as the red four players, we have Raspelmus and the guy from Holland. And spot on the bottom side as our blue four players, we have a true politician and Jack. Quick look on the army composition since the or a downloaded thing. Whenever I tried looking up the decks on the Wargame Red Dragon tools.com where I get the replays from, which if you have any Wargame Red Dragons replays, that would be nice if you send them to me because they're quite lacking. They don't really show the decks, and I always want to try to get the decks. It says error code 1. It looks like a true politician. It looks like it's United States, at least. It could be NORAD also. It is apparently United States with Marine base, maybe, or it could just be United States General. I can't really say, but looks like it's United States. And we do see a Challenger Marksman. So looks like Challenger Marksman is the, of course, the guy from Holland, because that is a British, along with the Saxon. Looks like he's British. He may have a Commonwealth in him. But we're going to have to wait and see if they deploy any other units. It looks like United States and British. You can see a chieftain that is also a British tank. The Canadians have what's it called? Centurions. We also see quite an eye. Looks like it is United States, a non-thematic, because there's of course the Bradleys, which is commonly mechanized. We also see the marine transports here. This is United States common, like non-thematic. And over here we have, can't really say if it is thematic or not. There is British. There could be Australian and Canadian in it. There could also be Canadian with the United States forces. But over here, let me take a quick look. It looks like there's going to be, I believe, looks like the Entente coalition from Rasbov. Raz move. We also got I think that's also that is the that's the Baltic a coalition. Yeah, it looks like there's Baltic and Entente versus United States and Britain, England, United Kingdom. There you go. Those are sorry about that. We do got a barrage. Look at a smoke barrage that covers units over here. Looks like he's sending over a AT gun and a number and an infantry squad. This is a elite infantry. Ooh, nice shot with the Harrier. And does destroy that, but does get shot down by the AA. Didn't manage to take out that particular AA, but it did get air superiority fire to take it down. There's an M1A2 Abrams here. That is the heavy tank, 170 point tank. And it's going to need to perform as 170 point tank because there's a lot of threats over here. A couple 120 points and a number of supporting units such as reconnaissance and infantry. In fact, one of those elite infantry because it's the infrared launcher. We got a longbow and ranger, so a bunch of reconnaissance units over here. Looks like we got units moving forward over here. Looks like they're just units meant to garrison the city. I think, but he went a little bit too far. That's a bit too far. Perhaps he's not going high for garrison city. You got Royal Marines. So far, it's all British units here. I don't see any Canadian or any what's it called? Either way, any Canadian or Australian unit, Anzac. We got another barrage come over here. It looks like it's going to be another smoke barrage that covers units. We do got the longbow getting some nice hits over here. We've got more infantry pushing in. The Royal Marines to decide to push fall back. Looks like we got a howitzer barrage over here. Nope, just a mortar barrage. Over here, a rifleman engaging infantry. The rifleman will get cleaned up. The M1A2 Abrams has fired a couple cannon shots, but nothing else. We got Nighthawk coming in with a bombing run. Will obliterate these transports and infantry. Only this scrap amount of units over here survives. We've got a Harrier engaging the anti-radar unit. Harrier will not take it out, but the Stormer may get it. The Patriot missile should turn around its back to weapon, but the Stormer does get the unit, destroying the anti-radar units. These anti-radar units are quite valuable, and they don't come very often. Chiefs engaging the cavalry tank of the Charlotteers. Challenger Marksman has a significant amount of armor, so it can actually withstand even the Charlotteers. ARV is trying to engage if ARVEs are effective versus infantry with its mortar pistol type unit. Evens in here is also going to provide support. Royal Marines are starting to fall back. They're of course going to have to fall back through open ground, which is a bit of a problem. Transports with the heavy tank of the Americans coming forward. We got Riflemen 90s more or less awkwardly down the middle of the field. Cavalry tanks are starting to push forward. We got transports. These transports are basic. They don't equip an MG. Good at soaking up some shots, but nothing really else. We got supply vehicles coming in. We also got an anti-tank multi-role aircraft coming forward. The anti-tank it's going to eye for the Abrams. It could get the Abrams. Double miss. Hornet's trying to gauge. Looks like the Patriot does clean that up. Eurofighter's coming forward trying to air superiority versus air superiority. Looks like neither of them gets shot down. This one has sustained some damage, probably from the gun. Radar missiles, and Patriot does take down the air superiority fighter. The Eurofighters will make it out scot-free. Abrams coming forward. Looks like it has sustained some damage. Maybe that, no, it had to be from an AT launcher. That multi-role jet would have done much more damage, even if it hit the frontal armor and not the top armor. This from the elite infantry. With the two machine guns, it can easily make good work, short work of these infantry squad. Plus the main gun will also help. Does it destroy that transport vehicle? And the Abrams get hit by a armor shot, takes 2 points of damage. Over here, we got the cavalry tanks moving forward. The Challenger Marksman has its weapon jammed. With its 17 frontal armor, it can withstand most shots from the light from the cavalry tanks, but if it's weapon jammed, it cannot fight back. We got a marine tank coming forward. It's one of the few heavy tanks that can be transported by sea. I think the only one that can be transported by sea. Destroy whatever vehicle that was, but it's going to hit now the Charlotteer, and the Charlotteer will have just die to it. Centurion ARVs will prevent any infantry from advancing this location without any support of smoke. You got Harrier coming in, does nice barrage right there. We got Rangers engaging the spas, the glars. I don't even want to make attempt to pronounce that unit. But the Rangers will be cleaned up. There's a lot of infantry in the area, including elite infantry. And it's actually their MG is turned off. They probably should turn that MG back on. Squad of riflemen, two squads of riflemen. The elite infantry is actually still up. Where did the Abrams go? Looks like the Abrams was killed. Bit of a shame. It must have been this team must have got nice rear armor. No, they have still plenty of AT missiles. Must have been an aircraft that took it out or something. Yeah, there's a multi-role aircraft here. Must have took it out. We got some Challenger 2s, the British heavy tank. The high is the tank with the most amount of frontal armor in the game. Ooh, the Eurofighter does go down. There's a couple of radar AA base units in the area somewhere. Unless it got intercepted. There they are. Must have taken out that Eurofighter. Eurofighter is one of the stronger air superiority aircraft in the game. Rangers are still alive unless though that blah 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 buzz that was over there. You got a significant amount of reservists. These are reserve infantry. They're only good for holding the point, but not very good for attack. They're also very slow. They move at 15 kilometers per hour in comparison to regular infantry 20, shocks with 25 and light at 25, and elites at 30 kilometers per hour. Got a barrage of missiles coming in, though largely missed everything. They'll miss at a couple forest fires. Got a couple transports and Centurion ARVs will still prevent infantry from engaging this crossing from this field. You got the LAV scout will come forward. It may be able to take out this elite infantry, assuming if it finds it first, and stay out of range. Otherwise, not the elite infantry. Using concealment may be able to get a quick kill off this unit. We do got a reconnaissance squad. It will fire the missile. Does destroy that vehicle. The infantry should pop out unless it gets a nice kill. Looks like it can kill that squad. The two LAV scouts does some nice damage in there. So he, a bit of a shame, but he lost the squad inside also. We got a Harrier. Strafe something there. I'm not sure what. I don't see any downed corpses, any vehicle corpses, so it might have been infantry. Oh, there is something there. Looked like an infantry body that was there. Reserve infantry time to move forward, but of course these vehicles will make short work of reservists. Reconnaissance aircraft move forward. There is no AA in the area, except he is going to deploy a Bradley with a Bradley IFV with TOW 2 missiles and a Stinger team. Probably a LAD C. Or Stinger C, whatever the C variant is, the better variant, I guess. So he's firing his AT missiles upon these ground units, but not getting any hits. We'll fire one last, but he missed all thanks to that stun. It is, and in fact, the Rangers do manage to take down that squad. Very nice. Smoke barrage will cover these reserve infantry, but these reserve infantry will melt away at first sign of trouble. The better, best versus these garrison buildings. Rangers will probably clean out this opposing reconnaissance squad, with plus with some help with this IFV, not IFV, but reconnaissance transport. Let's see, Red 4 does have a lead in the overall total points, and they're trying to move forward more capture vehicles. So the Blue 4 team may need to send a capture vehicle to over here and perhaps somewhere to somewhere else, or try to destroy their opponents. Reserve infantry are starting to be picked away. The heavy tank of the United States will rip apart these squads, plus the transports will create some chain stunning. Nice rocket barrage, but getting no good hits will stun a couple squads. The reserve infantry will get melted away. This elite infantry squad still alive. I wonder where that Bradley. The Bradley is coming up. Quite a number of squads of infantry over here. We also got these cavalry tanks doing some nice damage. Does pick off a transport and kill off the infantry that was inside. Reconnaissance infantry trying to engage. We also got some anti-tank teams. We got the U.S. Marines here, shock infantry for the United States, plus there's nearby IFV with a frag launcher. Frag launcher is basically one of the best anti-infantry weapons, especially on top of a vehicle. You got the LAT-C being deployed out, and the Bradley's also moving forward over this direction. Got a couple assault guns coming forward. I won't really see them being that too effective. While they may take out this transport, but that's probably it, taking out transports. They'll have nothing versus the Challenger 2 or the Abrams tank or the IFV. In fact, this IFV with the TOW missiles can take out those vehicles quite easily. Rangers moving forward. No riflemen, not Rangers. He could garrison this building. Oh, but these assault guns will manage to take out the infantry. These are fire support, not tank destroyers. Frag launchers are going to engage these infantry squads. Of course, they have pretty bad accuracy. Don't know how somebody can be that bad accuracy was having that big of spread, but it is what it is. These riflemen will be cleaned up by the IFVs. The transport does take a couple hits from the fire support. Ooh, nice barrage from the Harrier. Oh, there's a couple AA in the area. Looks like may get this EA Prowler. couple anti-radar. It looks like it did destroy one of those AA units by... In fact, yeah, there's one or two get destroyed. One that, Prowler got cleaned up. Not sure. It looks like the IFE was cleaned up. The Stormer HMV has no suitable targets. Could hit the 85 reconnaissance units, but it looks like it has been spotted. Ooh, nice hit from the tank. It only has three missiles left, which can take out these assault guns. This actually apparently takes more than one missile hit. We got a small team. This is a fire support unit, so they can fire their rocket upon these infantry squads. The T-72s are engaging. The small team apparently will be cleaned up by the mortar team primarily. Royal Marines are engaging the various Chikaris. We got Nighthawk. It's been a while since we saw a barrage come back. It has received the hit. It may get shot down. No, it does not. The MiG does also hit it. The missiles went straight to the T-72s, which took them out on the half health. Ultimately, probably not worth because it has extremely long reload speed, but nonetheless, it will stun and damage these vehicles, plus the firewalls prevent the units from approaching anymore. In fact, there's actually a capture vehicle here. Nice hit with the EA Prowler will destroy that radar base AA. In fact, there's no more radar base AA I can see here. These Royal Marines will be barraged by the mortar team. As Jakari and Jakaris are trying to engage the Royal Marines. I think Royal Marines are either shock or elites. I think the shocks. Some Marines are elites based on various factions, but those are usually commando Marines. The Royal Marines are shocks. Armament will secure these buildings. Though there is a number of, I think these are shock. They could be standard. But this Challenger 2 will make short work of it. But there is a... But wait, his TV guide missiles were off, which is a bit of a problem. If the vehicle is stunned and does get picked off by the Lad C, the Lad Stinger C. Looks like we got a couple IFEs implying. Actually, no, that's not IFE. It has a auto cannon on top, but so has a main gun. We got Abrams here. This is more of a medium type Abrams. It's like a 100 and I think this is a 100 point variant of the Abrams. So it is a quite strong tank, more of a medium to heavy. In the Jakari, he needs might need to withdraw the CV soon. Ooh, nice Harrier hit. More Harriers. Promising the damn attacks, but they are very weak AA, more good for stunning helicopters, my personal opinion. Ooh, just barely managed to get out of there. You got T-72 coming up. Oh, the left side we got the blah 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 blahs. I don't even bother trying to pronounce that. He has a CV. Oh wait, that's Red 4. That's Red. Get the CV. That is the Red 4 player. Ping saying he should kill the CV. In fact, the CV is not guarded at the moment. He needs to get back. He is falling back. The T-72 did not get a shot off. It was aiming up a shot, but he's going to be going open ground, which will leave him quite vulnerable. But we do see a Harrier coming forward. But it does get cleaned up by the various AA units in the area. We got a rocket barrage, but it does stun, but not kill. This helicopter may be cleaned up. Yeah, it does get shot down by the various MGs. The Abrams is engaging the infantry squad. They may clean up the infantry squad before it gets hit by AT. Yes, it does. But the two tanks are engaging. Nope, they just stay out of range. The Chikaris are moving forward. T-72 does get a hit. The Abrams does also get a hit. Next shot will kill. T-72 will win out. The transports. Oh, no, this is a tank. And looks like the Hornet will take it out. But it does get killed, cleaned up by the AA. We got a Prowler trying to hit the Ferengi radar. There's a couple smalls coming forward. I know those are smalls. Currently, the point is neutralized, the point variance, but the blue 14 managed to reclaim 8 points versus the 83. This CP is going forward, incredibly dangerous. There's no supporting squad, so he has a general idea that the opposing squads are over here. But with nothing really to support, it's very dangerous. We got anti-radar aircraft coming in by the Red 4 faction. But there's no really stopping this assault over here. There's a couple T-72s probably going to come up the end of the tree line to provide any fire support. I don't think they're going to advance because he doesn't know what exactly is over here. We got an EA Prowler that is the anti-radar unit. We got some Sopels. Those are anti-aircraft by gun but not by radar. We got some reserve infantry. These LAVs, LAV reconnaissance IFVs should make short work of them. The Abrams should also help. Though there is a T-72 coming forward. Sobol looks like shot down some sort of helicopter. The LAVs were cleaned up by the T-72. This M11P Abrams will rip apart these reserve squads, but it's getting hit by the T-72 in the frontal armor. His main gun has changed towards the T-72. It has received a hit, but it's going to take another couple more shots. The Abrams need to pull back into the smoke cover. The Abrams does go down by the T-72. We got a radar base AA, doesn't hit, and in fact, along with the MiG, will destroy that aircraft. We do got a basic AA engaging these transports. It will stun, chain stun the entirety of the group. The T-55 reconnaissance tank will probably eventually clean it up. But it's getting stunned by himself. He needs... I agree. That AA piece did a great job installing. This is going to be a push into the point over here. And sort of perhaps camping the spawn over here. We do got a longbow here. There is a promet that's stunned. There is also a infrared based launching teams. We also got a couple more AA units. Hopefully they can provide as much. Nope, looks like this unit's not going forward. I don't think they realized that the unit was engaging. Got some reserve infantry still being picked apart by the Abrams tanks. But this reconnaissance tank should clear up these AA units, but will have may have a bit of trouble. But that range, not so much. Let's get a stun and miss. Let's reduce the health by one. Is chain stunning it. Suppressive fire. And stun it again before it can fire. Yep. The power of the Vulcan. We got a fire support team here. Didn't manage to get a shot off that time, but it missed. In fact, the AA unit slowly optic failure. You can't see the unit now. And stunned again. The Vulcan cannon may clean out, but it is running out of ammo. Iron computer reset. And he's out of ammo. He did stall it. He was actually down to his very last of health. He could bring forward the frag launcher and hope to get... remove it, but you may run to the other AA. That's just funny to me. We got another front line. He has reinforced this area with a lot of riflemen, a couple smalls to support. We got some IFEs with frag launchers. In fact, he has a lot of infantry. Smalls do get a nice couple hits, but didn't really do that much. Do got some riflemen in these buildings. Do got a rocket barrage. Perhaps it's smoke. Perhaps it's explosive. Yes, it is smoke. Let's get a nice strafe with the Harrier. Over here, we do got a nice anti-tank team of some sort. Yeah, it looks like it was this squad here. We do got another heavy tank. At most, you can deploy is up to three of these heavy tanks. It seems they're unvetted. I would say he has all three available. This is someone I know of that's been deployed on the field. You got IFBs coming forward with frag launchers. They can do some serious damage, especially these grouped up units. They may get these supply vehicles. Rifleman moving forward. He has lost quite a number of riflemen. We do got some medium tanks. They're not exactly great versus other tanks, but they are effective versus infantry. Frag launchers are engaging. These frag launchers are hitting these valuable squads of grouped up men. And these frag launchers will rip apart these squads. Riflemen have been cleaned up over here, but he has dislodged his opponent's infantry force here. Though there's still some heavy tanks here, which can be a bit of a problem. But still the significant force. Maybe a Nighthawk bombing ground would have been nice there. We do got the Nighthawk coming from this direction. There are a couple Sopels here. The Harrier is going to draw the fire. The Harrier is going to escape out the nice hit over here. I'm not exactly sure. Destroyed. Looks like the AA is still in the area. CV did get stunned. EA Prowler, not going to see any radar-based AA at the time. Do got the Block C. Block F-16C-52. Block just means what's type of loadout, really. Riflemen are now engaging Jakari, though they are lacking men. These tanks may sway the fire battle. The T-72 will clean up these transports with frag launchers. Note they are amphibious also. Looks like we got some light tanks coming forward. And some radar base AA, another T-72. Looks like those squads were cleaned up. There's still this T-72, which is a bit of a problem for this force here. Granted, the Abrams can deal with it if it gets dropped on it. In fact, this T-72, I believe, was hit by the Nighthawk earlier in the game. So it is low on our health. And Abrams can finish off with a nice shot if it gets close enough. We got this Abrams tank, a more heavier variant, coming forward also. You got a barrage coming forward. Looks like it's definitely going to be a rocket barrage. I don't think that's going to be smoke. In fact, it's coming over here. Or right there, hitting nothing. Looks like he's going to send out a bunch of LAV scouts. He will find this force here. Another nice couple of barrages. I don't think that's from the mortar. I think, yeah, we do see have the two or three howitzers coming forward, which they are effective versus pretty much all targets. In fact, he may get this CV even though it's moved. Yes, he does get the CV. That's a very nice pickup. Allow the Red 14 to maintain their point advantage lead. I'll take a bit of a drink. Yes, how American am I to just drink straight out of a 2-liter? My drink today is Fresca. The light tanks, the cavalry tanks have been spotted, though the Abrams should pick them off one by one, but getting some misses and actually not picking them off instantly, so it will take some time. We do got the Salamander coming forward, the Salamandra. It's trying to use its AT missiles, but in order to be effective, he needs to be standing still. This heavy tank did receive a hit, but of course, it has quite strong frontal armor, so it's taking minimum damage. The IFEs managed to shoot down the helicopter, and this tank managed to clean up the rest of the cavalry tanks. We do got a barrage coming forward. Let's take out Rifleman Squad. Very minor pickup. You got a massive airstrike coming forward. Carriers. Nice, some hits. Does stun some of the AA. Does lose one through the mass promets. Promets in large numbers can take out units. Does destroy the CV. Very nice. And will help get the tickets counting in their favor. My support team is engaged in IFVs. The IFVs may win out, but of course, at this close range, these fire support teams can do quite a bit of damage. And getting some nice stun hits, and it looks like it will finish the winning off the IFVs. There are a couple T-72s coming forward. In fact, the riflemen, if they can come in around behind, hit the rear armor, they could destroy these T-72s with ease. Does lose the transport there. This Abrams tank is going to get a nice hit at close range with maximum penetration, but barely not enough destroying it. With losing with only one health left, that's still one health enough to live. We do got this heavy tank coming forward. We also got this capture vehicle coming up. A bit more exposed over here, but with his infantry providing a buffer and without being as obvious a hit barrage right here, it will help secure, equalize the points with plus two non-favor. In fact, he was spotted. He was spotted. Now there's going to be mortars, artillery. Yeah, it looks like the artillery is going to bring the pain and just quickly destroy that vehicle. But he is bringing up the CV, is bringing up the, even out the ticket points. If he can just get slightly ahead, he will be the win both while the game still, still probably considered as a draw. In fact, it's probably close enough to be considered a draw at this point. As the 203s are now lining up their shots, T-72s are engaging the infantry. We've got the a smoke barrage, perhaps trying to aid in retreating T-72s. There is a brief moment where he still had line of sight, but no longer. He may attack. He is hitting the transports actually coming behind, so he actually does have a line of vision. But he's smart about bringing his T-72s back along this way, using the cover of smoke as much as he can. I would imagine a Harrier or two will probably engage this area soon. He does pull back the CV, does sustain a lot of damage, but as long as he's alive, it can still do a job. In fact, he has. They also have brought up their own CV to neutralize the capture rate. This heavy tank has sustained a hit, but it's down to half health, which half health is still fine, can still engage the opponent. More Abrams coming forward. Rifleman is being cleaned up, and there is quite a number of Jakari here, so it can't be overwhelmed. We got a rocket barrage coming forward, however. Not exactly sure where that's going to land. Trying to eye for the CV. The CV is still here, and the points are now actually in favor of the blue 4 fat team. Now they need to get as much of a lead as possible so they can actually be declared the winners. At this point in the game, though, they will still be considered a draw. Yes, they also spotted this CV. That's something else to point. There will be a 203 howitzer barrage coming out soon. And then, however, there's a brief moment there. Never mind. Just a fire dislodging the CV of this player. There is a now barrage coming forward. Does get a nice hit. Does stun it. There may be a follow-up shot. There may be a moving. He may not be paying attention at the time because probably maybe focusing over here. They did destroy that CD, and that is preventing the tickets counting up in favor of the blue 4 team. Now they're neutralized out. If they can dislodge this CV, then they can try to neutralize the score, even it out to make it definitely to a draw. Smalls are engaging forward, though they are doing quite decent work. I'm also not a fan of using smalls myself. A couple promets will immediately wipe this squad down. But he may get this this infrared team, but apparently he will not. And once again, the small misses, and the promets are going to lay into the squad and kill it. So the Nighthawk, oh! That was definitely the Nighthawk. But luckily, you can't really say team kill because that was his own units. A bit unfortunate on his own part, but It could have been worth. I honestly cannot say. You got an F-18C Hornet. Probably should note that this little thing invasion has kind of ultimately been cleaned up since units there. You got the F-18 engaging. Note it is a multi-role aircraft equipped with anti-tank missiles and close-range infrared missiles. Lots of barrage. They do manage to destroy the CV, and now the points are ticking up in favor of the Red 4 team. The points about ready to be neutralized. Do we see any CVs, capture vehicles coming up? There's this extra one here, which they could move up, but I don't think they realize it just yet. Sometimes you don't realize the score if you're one in the heat of the moment. Over here, we've got reserve infantry engaging. Riflemen are trying to move forward. Riflemen will make short work of the squad, but we do have elite infantry with frag launchers, which can do a significant amount of damage, but they're down to three men, so they don't have many men left. And also we got the IFE laying into them, so it looks like that frag team will get destroyed. They are elite infantry, so if that's important. We got a capture vehicle here, so the points are now going 0-0, and the Red 4 team are ahead by 10 points, which can be changed in a hat toss. And with 5 minutes left, this game will most likely end up a draw if the Blue 4 team will keep the points how it is. However, they need to get another capture vehicle or displace this one in order for them to actually be a bit more meddled out. If the Red 4 team gets a little bit more number of points, then they will win. In fact, with this CV being moved around, they probably will actually be declared the victors in this game. You've got apparently incendiary barrage and a high explosive barrage coming in. Reserve infantry are being cleaned up. We do got this anti-tank team, which shouldn't be moving up. The reserve infantry have 14 men in comparison to riflemen 8 men. But the reserve infantry are focused on the squad of riflemen, so perhaps maybe we should hop in this building. Challenger is being re-armored. It apparently has sustained a lot of damage. Salamandra is now engaging. Has some rocket pods. Did lay into an infantry squad. But there is a Lad C Stinger squad here. And one more hit and it is dead. And it has 70% accuracy, if I remember correctly. And does destroy it. Over here, we got another engagement. The points are currently ticking up in favor of the Blue 4 team. They can neutralize the points. Do got a nice Harriers. We've got a Nighthawk coming forward. This is going to be a massive hit, destroying a lot of IFVs. Does destroy the CV, so now they're ticking up plus 2 in their favor. If they hold these plus 2 for the rest of the game, they could actually be declared the victors. Instead of the game declaring it as a draw. So there is a T-72s engaging over here. We do got a longbow engaging, which are very effective versus tanks, but I don't think it has any vision at the moment. It looks like just trying to hit the IFVs or transports. Got some more Bradleys coming forward. We got a rocket barrage coming over here. The Abrams tank is actually running low on ammo. Note this is just a machine gun transport, so the threat of it actually doing something is very minor. The riflemen's actually running low on ammo themselves. Shooting reserve militia tends to take a lot out of the ammunition. Nice hit from the F-18 Hornet. Destroyed one of the T-72s. This capture vehicle is right here. In fact, the Blue 4 team has sustained a lot of plus tickets in their favor. In fact, quite a bit. They're getting plus 2 now, even though this... in fact, there's actually 2 capture vehicles. That's why I saw this one moving. I was wondering why... It was moving what they said out of area control. This TACCOM squad will probably be cleaned up, though there is the longbow engaging the transports. Over here we got reserve infantry engaging riflemen. The riflemen will win out. They have IFV support. We've got some assault guns moving forward. The Rangers should be able to handle it. Harrier's moving forward, make engaging the Harrier. The Harrier does get shot down. With this MiG, it's actually a multi-role. The MiG does get shot down by the by the F-16 Fighting Falcon. But the Fighting Falcon does get destroyed by Radar Base AA. A lot of aircraft just going down. There's only 2 minutes left in the game. Might as well throw everything you got into everything your opponent has. With a 50-point lead for the Blue 14 and still counting up, I think the game will decide the victor is the Blue 14. We got a MiG coming in with bombs. Bombs are being dropped in this gen. No, it's actually being dropped back here. He's trying to aim for splashing down the longbow. He will splash down the longbow. If Nighthawk is engaging, launching bombs down this capture vehicle, does destroy the capture infantry, I should say. And the radar did not pick up and destroy the aircraft. It's down to two missiles, so it's significantly running out of missiles. One of these supply vehicles should go over there and refill it. Down to the last minute of the game. I would say this is actually now decisively in the Blue 4 team's favor. With Abrams coming forward, riflemen closing this position, that area will soon be dislodged. Nothing over here to contend with the rifle, with these units. These Blue 4 infantry will storm in and secure the area. We got fire support teams engaging infantry. We got tanks in the forest, which is can be always very dicey which way it's going to go. But this T-72 probably will be cleaned up by the two Abrams. And a lot more riflemen support. The mortar over here has been cleaned. It's out of ammo, and the game is in favor of the Blue 4 team. Ooh. No wonder I saw a lack of British units. Looks like Jack quit the game in the middle of the game. That would be the only reason why Jack's points were so low. No wonder we haven't been seeing much of British units. I was wondering that in the back of my mind. Apparently he left the game. And that was very good. Played by a true politician. Let's see now. This is a very good game. And overall, well, Raspelmus didn't really fight that well. In comparison, he lost quite a bit in comparison to what he deployed. That guy from Holland did quite well. As you can see, also the rank difference in ranks gives a difference in capabilities. Of course, the people who are much higher rank has much more experience and know how to use their units much properly. Either way, this is a very good replay. This is Lord Agion saying thank you for watching and signing off.